She did not say it was good to see me again, as I had hoped she would do. Indeed, after the first minute of greeting, she seemed a trifle cool and distant. We walked for an hour in the pine wood and talked. Betty was brilliant, witty, self-possessed, altogether charming. I thought her perfect, and yet my heart ached. What a glorious young thing she was, in that splendid youth of hers! What a prize for some lucky man! Confound the obtrusive thought! No doubt we should soon be overrun at Glenby with lovers. I should stumble over some forlorn youth at every step. Well, what of it? Betty would marry, of course. It would be my duty to see that she got a good husband, worthy of her as men go. I thought I preferred the old duty of superintending her studies. But there, it was all the same thing, merely a postgraduate course in applied knowledge. When she began to learn life's greatest lesson of love, I, the tried-and-true old family friend and mentor, must be on hand to see that the teacher was what I would have him to be, even as I had formerly selected her instructor in French and botany. Then, and not until then, would Betty's education be complete. I rode home very soberly. When I reached the Maples, I did what I had not done for years, looked critically at myself in the mirror. The realization that I had grown older came home to me with a new and unpleasant force. There were marked lines on my lean face, and silver glints in the dark hair over my temples. When Betty was 10, she had thought me an old person. Now, at 18, she probably thought me a veritable ancient of days. Pshaw, what did it matter? And yet I thought of her as I had seen her, standing under the pines, and something cold and painful laid its hand on my heart. My premonitions as to lovers proved correct. Glenby was soon infested with them. Heaven knows where they all came from. I had not supposed there was a quarter as many young men in the whole county, but there they were. Sarah was in the seventh heaven of delight. Was not Betty at last a belle? As for the proposals, well, Betty never counted her scalps in public, but every once in a while a visiting youth dropped out and was seen no more at Glenby. One could guess what that meant.